John Airy here with AintItCool.com. Just got off a screen of Get the Gringo. It's Mel Gibson's new movie. AintItCool.com had a very special deal tonight where they screened the film not only here in Austin, but 9 other cities across the United States as well. After the screening, Mel and his kid co-star, producer, and director all sat down with Harry and had a live Q&A with all 10 theaters who watched the screen tonight. Very, very cool, very exciting.
Okay, this one's for Mel from Eric in L.A. Can we look forward to another Lethal Weapon movie?
Maybe, I don't know. I don't know who's going to make it or be in it or anything.
After the film screening, I pulled some random folks out of the audience and got their take on the movie.
Get the Gringo is about pretty much Mel jumping the border into Mexico and then having to deal with the worst prison of all time. And getting out of the worst prison of all time.
No one is totally good and no one is totally bad. You know, in terms of, you know, it goes back to Campbell and the whole hero cycle, but in a much grittier, more down-to-earth way.
Am I allowed to speak like abstractly? Because I think abstractly it means Mel Gibson is still here. And he's ready to absolutely like kick butt. If Liam Neeson can do it, Mel Gibson can do it. That's all I'm saying. The bright spots, the humor, obviously. Like this, I saw that Edge of Darkness, and that was all right. Like I thought, Mel Gibson, like he's grim, he's serious. But come on, Mel, you played that before. So like, just the fact that this is so raunchy and so, gosh, he's still having a fun time, you know.
Another thing I really did like was the kid. You gotta see the kid.
I was blown away. Blown away. It exceeded all my expectations in terms of the writing, the direction, the production design. Production design on this movie did blow me away, but that was very quickly overtaken by the quality of the writing, the acting. This just about gets right up there with Mad Max and the Thunderdome.
The action's really great. They referenced kind of in the Q&A tonight, Sam Peckinpah being kind of an inspiration for the film. There's a great, one particular moment in the film is a shootout in the center that's like very Peckinpah inspired, which is very fun.
I could say that the action was a little predictable, but like the last third, it did what a lot of action movies do. Like it's the first hour is just like, get it to the Gringo. The last 30 minutes is always like the exact same action movie that we see every other month come out. But it's the fact that Mel Gibson's still like in there. I think he carries it through. It's that charisma. The fact that we know him. He doesn't even have to try. He's still got it. I say see Get It to the Gringo, or maybe even wait just a few months until it like comes out on DVD.
We're gonna go, we're gonna sneak back in again, and we're gonna see it again.
Encore.
We're gonna see it again, right now. We're gonna like totally.
Right now, let's just go.
Yeah, let's go. Okay.
My take on the movie, I really enjoyed it. It's not Mel Gibson's best movie, but to me it's sort of like a mashup between Fistful of Dollars and maybe like a sequel to Payback. It definitely feels like Payback in a lot of different ways. The character is practically the same, just in a Mexican prison. It's good stuff. I definitely suggest checking it out on video on demand if you have a chance. But I'd love to know what you think. Leave your comments below and keep checking back in with AintItCool.com for the latest news and reviews. I'm John Airy.